We're asked to consider the sequence 5, 8, 11, 14, 17, 20, 23, and so on, with a sub 1 equal to 5. For part A, we're asked to find the sum using the technique discussed in the text. Before we do this, we first need to recognize that the given sequence is an arithmetic sequence. Notice how the terms are increasing by 3. 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. 8 plus 3 is equal to 11. 11 plus 3 is equal to 14. 14 plus 3 is equal to 17, and so on. We can also say the terms in the sequence have a common difference. Notice 8 minus 5 is 3. 11 minus 8 is 3. 14 minus 11 is 3, and so on. So we have an arithmetic sequence where d, the common difference, is equal to 3. And before we can find the sum below, we need to know how many terms are in the sum. To do this, we'll first have to find the closed formula for the given arithmetic sequence, and then set 1,463 equal to a sub n and solve for n. So to find the closed formula, because a sub 1 is the first term, the closed formula is a sub n equals a sub 1 plus d times the quantity n minus 1. This gives us a sub n is equal to 5 plus 3 times the quantity n minus 1. Simplifying, we have a sub n is equal to 5 plus 3n minus 3, which gives us a sub n equals 2 plus 3n. So again, now we will set a sub n equal to 1,463 and solve for n. This gives us the equation 1,463 is equal to 2 plus 3n. And now to solve for n, we subtract 2 on both sides, which gives us 1,461 equals 3n. Then we divide both sides by 3, which gives us n is equal to 487. And since the first term is a sub 1, we now know the sum has 487 terms. And now to find the sum using the technique discussed in the text, not using the partial sums formula below, we begin by writing out the sum. We have s equals 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus a whole bunch more terms. We know the last term is 1,463. The term before this, though, would be 3 less, which would be 1,460. So let's write plus 1,460 plus 1,463. And now we're going to write the sum again in reverse order. We have s equals 1,463 plus 1,460 plus dot, dot, dot. The last two terms are going to be plus 8 plus 5. And now we add the two equations together. On the left, we have s plus s, which is 2s equals, and on the right, when we add, we're always going to have the same sum. Notice 5 plus 1,463 is 1,468. The next sum is also 1,468. In fact, all the sums are 1,468. So the question is, how many 1,468s are we adding? Well, because the sum has 487 terms, we know we're adding 487 1,468s, which means you can write the equation as 2s equals 487 times 1,468. And now from here, we can determine the sum s by dividing both sides by 2. Simplifying, we have s equals the product of 487 and 1,468, all divided by 2, which is 357,458. And now let's take a look at part B. Use what you found above to find b sub n, which is the nth term of 1, 6, 14, 25, 39, and so on, with b sub 0 equals 1. Well, this is a little bit tricky, but notice b sub 0 is equal to 1. B sub 1 is actually equal to 1 plus a sub 1, which is 5. Notice b sub 2 is equal to 1 plus a sub 1 plus a sub 2, which is equal to 1 plus 5 plus 8, which is 14, and so on. And therefore, b sub n is 1 plus the partial sums of the arithmetic sequence above. Using the same technique we used in part A, rather than the partial sums formula on the bottom, let's set this up on the next slide. We'll begin by listing out B sub n as a sum, where B sub n is equal to 1 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus, we know the last term is going to be plus a sub n, which we found as 2 plus 3n. The term before 2 plus 3n is going to be 3 less, which is negative 1 plus 3n. And again, using the same technique, we are now going to reverse the sum. However, b sub n is 1 plus the partial sum of the arithmetic sequence. So we'll leave the 1 in the first position and reverse the remaining terms. So we can also write b sub n as 1 plus 2 plus 3n plus negative 1 plus 3n. The next term would be 3 less than negative 1 plus 3n, which is negative 4 plus 3n, dot, 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 plus the last two terms we would sum would be 8 and 5, giving us plus 8 plus 5. And now we're going to use the same technique and add the two equations together. Again, what's a little bit challenging about this one is this value of 1 is not reversed because we're only reversing the sum of the arithmetic sequence, which starts at 5. So adding, we have 2 times b sub n equals 2 plus, and now the remaining sums should all be the same. 5 plus the quantity 2 plus 3n is 7 plus 3n, and the remaining sums should also all be 7 plus 3n. 8 plus the quantity negative 1 plus 3n is 7 plus 3n. So is 11 plus the quantity negative 4 plus 3n. Plus dot 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 plus, again, negative 1 plus 3n plus 8 is 7 plus 3n, plus another 7 plus 3n. And now the question becomes, how many 7 plus 3n's are we adding? Well, there are n terms in the sum starting with 5 and ending with the last term of 2 plus 3n, which means we can write the equation as 2 times b sub n equals 2 plus n times the quantity 7 plus 3n. And now we divide both sides by 2 to solve for b sub n. We have b sub n is equal to 2 divided by 2 plus n divided by 2 times the quantity 7 plus 3n. Simplifying one last time, we have b sub n is equal to 1 plus n divided by 2 times the quantity 7 plus 3n. So here we have the closed formula for b sub n. Now you may want to compare this to the video I made where we use the partial sums formula below for the sum of an arithmetic sequence or an arithmetic series. I hope you found this helpful.